Υπότιτλοι AUTHORWAVE. Thank you. They thank him for and his wife for their lovely performance.
As you know, we now have an English translation that is now being officially made here for the and presented by the Archdiocese. And the English text was approved and adapted by the Holy Synod of the Greek Orthodox Archdiocese of America. And from now on, all of the English that we use must be from this particular text. So the ipermacho that we're going to say, we're going to sing it in Greek, but the English translation, the official English translation is, "To you, defender and commander, in a time of war, I, your city, offer gratitude for victory. For you rescued me from sufferings, O Theotokos, since the power you possess is unassailable. From all dangers, I entreat you to deliver me, that I may cry to you, rejoice, O unwedded bride." just to read the English, now the official English translation to the Magnificat or the Axion of Steve. It is truly right to bless you, Theotokos. Ever blessed, most pure, and mother of our God. More honorable than the cherubim, and beyond compare, more glorious than the seraphim. Without corruption, you gave birth to God the Logos. We magnify you, the true Theotokos.
Year and a half ago that Evelyn Chaya, our choir director, speak, like, he composed a piece for the choir in commemoration of the 100th anniversary of the church. She suggested the Night of the Cock as a text, and that text in itself was really the perfect text for our church, the Dormition of the Virgin Mary. The text itself is Mary's own prayer and exaltation to God for choosing her, for deeming her the most pure vessel through which Christ could enter our world as a human. Because the text is so important, when I composed this, I tried to make sure that either the voices are generally singing the text at the same time, or that if one voice part has the text, the others are below it with a hum, so that you can always hear the importance of the words. You may notice when you listen to it that the soprano, the highest female voice, always has the text, and that is to represent the voice of the Virgin Mary. I just want to thank Evelyn for working so hard, not just to run this herself, but to teach it to the choir, to all my fellow choir members who have Lent and Holy Week music to learn, who have taken time out of their lives to come to rehearsals and learn this piece. I wrote it for our church choir, which has one male singer total. So there's only one bass part for both tenors and basses to sing. Little did I know I'd have the pleasure of this many wonderful singers coming forward to sing this with us. So I'm so grateful to all of them for being here. To Sophia for playing the organ along with us and moving the organ around various places to try to find the right spot for her. And to everybody who has come out to make time out of the day to be part of this.
Join us in our church hymn.